Question for you, different sport. If I'm a runner and I'm training and I'm practicing running, how do I know if I'm getting better? What would be the first thing we would do to test that if a runner is getting better? And the first thing we would do, simply, is we time them. And whatever race it is, we're gonna time them to see if there's progress being made. And what is that? That's an assessment, that's a test. Then why in baseball, when we're doing ground balls, all off season, we're working in a cage, or you're working on the pitcher's mound, why do we not assess whether we're getting better or not? And who's determining whether we're getting better, and what does better mean? Well, the same thing has to take place. A simple, well, that feels good, or your coach or instructor saying, looks good to me, oh yeah, that's better, may pump up your ego. But how do we truly define what better is? And we have to put objective numbers against that. So I'm gonna give you a couple different scenarios here in different training scenarios of how we can mark improvement. One, are we getting stronger? The off season's the most important time for our nutrition and our strength building phases. So in the weight room, obviously we can mark, am I getting stronger by seeing, am I able to complete more reps or can I lift more weight? With nutrition, am I putting on healthy weight? Get on a scale, that's an objective number. But again, when I go back to baseball, that swing looks good is not an objective number. And although our coach may be, like I said, pumping you up and feeding your ego, we have to put some objective numbers against that. So here's two ways to test that when we're in a batting cage. One, we are marking exit velocity. Exit velocity is gonna tell us if you're working on your swing for power purposes, am I getting faster with my exit velocity of the ball? Marking your bat speed with a sensor like Diamond Kinetics. Am I seeing that the bat speed is improving? And those things are gonna go up and down at times, but we wanna see somewhat of a line that's showing improvement and gaining of speed. But one of the hardest things to do to mark performance in a batting cage is determine whether you're truly becoming a better hitter or not. Because oftentimes we're working off of a tee, building our swing, I'm doing some sort of front toss, and again, we see that the ball's coming off the bat and it feels good, but the true test is in a game, in a competition. And in competition, the ball is coming a lot harder and we're having to just react. And then we, of course, we're seeing what the ball is doing in a game that determines my level of performance. So how can we do that in a cage setting? Well, we have to compete there too. We have to go against live setting batting practice from time to time, and it doesn't have to be all the time, but that's a way that we're gonna assess where we're at right now. There's time in the batting cage where I'm working on thinking. I'm saying in this drill, we're thinking and feeling. I want you to be reflective of what your body feels like. Then when we do our front toss, we still have a level of comprehension of what I'm trying to get done with my body and what that feels like. But when I'm going against that live test, which is batting practice, changing speeds, and throwing hard, that's the assessment, that's reaction, that's game-like. And that's how you can make your practice setting more game-like and beneficial to see, are we truly making progress? It's not meant to frustrate you, it's seeing, where are we? Are we truly gaining any progress there? And it has to be evaluated in a testing setting, because oftentimes in the off-season, you're not playing games, and that's fine. Training time is important, but during training time, if you're not assessing, what's gonna happen is we get it out on the field, we felt good all off season, then all of a sudden in the game we're failing, and I have Johnny's dad coming back to the cage in panic mode because we spent all this money and time in the off season, and it's not showing up initially in a game. Then there's other factors that can go into that with anxiety, adrenaline, even depth perception, differences from indoors to outdoors that come about. A lot of things could come into factor there. But if we're not assessing during the year, by going live off the mound, throwing strikes, checking velocity, doing it in a cage, or putting competition in your ground ball routine, then we don't really know if we're getting better. So that's the one thing I have for this off season. Don't just work on your fundamentals. Work on your fundamentals, test and assess, and do that periodically to see if you truly are getting better. Till next time, this is Justin Stone with ElitePaseball.tv, and we'll see you on the field.